It has come. Sparks, shocks, ignitions, and then another failed attempt. But relentlessly, over a decade, since 1998, the mighty space explorer called the CERN Large Hadron Collider continually went through the undying passion of a relentless team made up of hundreds of scientists setting an incredible pace in space. They had watched and waited patiently to see this mind-blowing invention revolutionize knowledge and the understanding of the universe. That is to say, the Large Hadron Collider was the wonder that would reveal unfathomable mysteries that had been kept hidden. Well, just as the Large Hadron Collider had been successfully built and created to unravel mysteries in space, recently, scientists from CERN announced that when they put on the Large Hadron Collider with a new maximum beam of energy, something terrible was discovered out in space, which was kept all scientists and researchers very awestruck. What could that be? I guess you just asked that question. Well, stick around, because in this video, you're about to be blown away after the disclosure of what this is. You must have also been eager to know what the CERN Large Hadron Collider means. Well, not to worry. Let's have a clear insight into the LHC. The Large Hadron Collider, or LHC, is the world's biggest and most potent particle accelerator, sited 100 meters, or about 328 feet, underground, beneath the border between France and Switzerland. It first started up in September 10, 2008, and remains the latest acquisition of CERN's accelerator complex. The LHC consists of a 27-kilometer coil of superconducting magnets, with several revving layouts to raise the energy of the particles along the path. The LHC was constructed to study minuscule subatomic particles, which are the tiniest known units of matter and the construction blocks of all things. But the collider itself is the biggest and most intricate machine ever assembled by man. At maximum energy, trillions of protons will speed around the LHC accelerator coil more than 11,245 times a second, since they travel at 99.999% the speed of light. When this machine originally commenced operations, that meant it could arrange about 600 million collisions every second. But now differently, the photon beams will be constricted to less than 10 microns, which is about the width of 10 bacterial cells. To boost the speed of collisions, according to CERN's head of accelerators and technology, Mike Lamont, who spoke to AFP, with the thinner beam, scientists are seeking to deliver 1.6 billion collisions per second. The collision of the two beams produces temperatures surpassing 100,000 times hotter than the hottest part of the sun, which is the core. Although that heat will be centralized in a very small space, such temperatures are being developed, and the machine's accelerator ring will be maintained a cool minus 271.3 degrees Celsius using superfluid helium. In an attempt to apprehend our universe, including its mode of operation and its fundamental layout, scientists presented a theory called the Standard Model. This theory attempts to describe and elucidate the fundamental particles that make up the universe what is. It merges elements from Einstein's theory of relativity with quantum theory. It also deals with three of the four basic forces of the universe: strong nuclear force, weak nuclear force, and electromagnetic force. It does not talk about the effects of gravity, the fourth fundamental force. The Standard Model makes several projections about the galaxy, many of which appear authentic according to myriad of investigations, but other parts of the model remain unconfirmed. One of those is the theoretical particle called the Higgs boson. The Higgs boson is called the God particle. It is an essential particle associated with the Higgs field, an area that provides mass to other essential particles, such as electrons and quarks. A particle's mass determines how greatly it fights its change in speed or status when it experiences a force. Not all fundamental particles have mass. The particle of light, called the photon, carries the electromagnetic force and has no mass at all. The Higgs boson was proposed in 1964 by Peter Higgs and François Englert and four other theorists to clarify why certain particles have mass. Scientists substantiated its presence in 2012 through the ATLAS and CMS experiments at the Large Hadron Collider at CERN in Switzerland. This finding led to the 2013 Nobel Prize in Physics being awarded to Higgs and Englert. Well, what did the LHC discover? Subsequently, after 3 years of upgrade and supervision work, scientists at CERN fired up the LHC in July, and on July 5th, they identified an unusual kind of pentaquark and the first ever couple of tetraquarks, which includes a unique type of tetraquark. Quarks are fundamental building blocks of matter, most commonly found inside protons and neutrons, which make up the nucleus of each atom in the universe. Protons and neutrons mainly consist of two types of quarks, called up and down quarks. The heavier duplicates of the up quark are called charm and top quarks. The duplicates of the down quark are named strange and bottom quarks. Quarks usually incorporate in groups of two or three to form hadrons, such as the protons and neutrons formed at the atomic nuclei. But they can also blend into four and five quark particles called tetraquarks and pentaquarks. The newest discoveries the LHC has discovered, a pentagon that holds a charm quark, a charm antiquark with an up and down quark, and the strange quark. It is the first to include a strange quark. This finding has an important statistical significance of 15 standard deviations, far beyond the 5 standard deviations that are needed to take over the observation of a particle in particle physics. While some theoretical models explain unknown hadrons as single units of tightly bound quarks, other models view them as pairs of ideal hadrons loosely bound in a molecular-like structure. Only time and more studies of exotic hadrons will tell if these particles are one, the other, or both. The discovery of new and exotic hadrons helps us understand the strong nuclear force that keeps quarks within the particle united. It is unclear if, in exotic hadrons, the quark all stick tightly together, or they form triples and couples that are loosely bound like molecules. More examination is necessary. LHC spokesperson Chris Parks said that finding new kinds of tetraquarks and pentaquarks and measuring their components will help theorists formulate a suitable model of exotic hadrons, the exact nature of which is largely unknown. It will also help to better comprehend conventional hadrons. Now, with all that being said, it definitely would occur to you the danger of this invention and its discovery might pose to human life. Could it be that scientists from over 1,000 universities came together to create a weapon that would be responsible for destroying the universe completely? The CERN Large Hadron Collider looks very scarier than what it was created to discover and what it has discovered. In the past, people have tried to sue CERN for creating a danger to public safety, hinting at an underlying fear about the side effects of using an unprecedented technology. The two main fears that surround the use of the Large Hadron Collider are black holes and early named strange matter. The first fear is pretty obvious. One of the LHC's goals is to simulate a microscopic black hole that contains clues about the Big Bang. Hearing this with little to no technical expertise sounds like a bad idea. The second fear revolves around the idea of high-energy LHC experiments could produce strangelets, a hypothetical material made up of strange matter that could infect the material that made up the rest of the Earth. That's a lot of quotation marks, and for good reason. Strange matter is, at the moment, purely hypothetical and hasn't been observed in outer space, where high-energy rays are bouncing around all over the place. The collider, a 16.6-mile underground racetrack that will shatter protons together, which will recreate situations from the beginning of the universe, is the most current example of a scientific experiment that looks into the public's deep well of doomsday fears. Robert Bartholomew, sociologist and author of 2001's Little Green Men, says that there is something in the human psyche that makes us examine some innovations or research with great apprehension, fearing that careless and selfless scientists will blow us to kingdom come. Meowing nuns and headhunting panics, a study of mass psychogenic illness and social delusion. People see what they expect to see in a search for certainty, especially during times of crisis, as they attempt to confirm their worst fears and greatest hopes. Physicists are hoping that the collider's brief period of operation will quell public fears. 2007 LHC Safety Group: such roton collisions cannot be hazardous. The group noted that the cosmic rays, radiation from stars, black holes, and elsewhere in space that, like the LHC protons, are submicroscopic, constantly hit the atmosphere with more oomph than the lab can retain without annihilating the Earth. Wow! There is a lot more to explore about the CERN Large Hadron Collider. We would definitely keep in touch and bring you to attention the changes in the most recent explorations and discoveries. Well, before then, tell us what you think about this gigantic collider by CERN and its discoveries in the comments section. Also, stay tuned to this channel for more jaw-dropping updates on adventures and current evolutions in the space niche. Click on the subscribe button to stay notified in all of our videos. See you in the next video.